Hey, the name is Grace Emphatic. I am a poet from Emakhanda, and I've been asked to tell you about my first wow moment at the Black Power Station. Every time I go there is a wow moment, so it's very hard to say like which was the wow moment, but I specifically remember the first time I went up there. It was last year, 2017, when it was quite late, you know, quite late at night. I think around about 8-9 o'clock, if it wasn't even 10 o'clock at night. So X, he sends me a text on WhatsApp and he's like, yo, we're going up to the power station, you wanna come? You know, I'm like, yeah, let's go. You know, it's like, cool, I'm gonna come pick you up, and then we go. So he comes, picks me up, and then we go up, because I hadn't been, like, he told me about the place before, but I just hadn't been there. I get there and I walk in, I'm just like, yo, what's going on? You know, like, crazy, like, it was a beautiful mess, if I can call it that. It was a beautiful, beautiful mess, because the first thing I remember just walking in, there was just all these empty bottles, you know, like, just filled up like a whole lot of the space, and there was like wood, there was old car chairs, like a whole lot of like old, like recyclable material, you know, like a whole lot of stuff that he was going to recycle to make the place what he wants it to become. And it was a beautiful mess because I could already envision, you know, like what it's going to be like when it's done, you know, just looking at the stuff that was there and the work that was being done, like, because some things were already in the process, like the stage was already in the process of being built. There was these young men that were just busy hammering down, you know, stuff and putting up stuff and lights and all those things, like, was epic. And he told me about the book corner, he told me the ideas that he had for the chairs, and you know, how he's going to use some of the tree stumps that were like outside to make chairs and to use, make tables and stuff like that, like on the inside. I was like, this guy's crazy, you know. You know, anyone else who would have walked in there who doesn't have as creative a mind as a typical artist, if I could put it that way, has, like, they would have looked at that and just like, this guy's crazy, this thing's not gonna happen, like, this is just a big mess, it's all big madness. But you know, from then till now, you know, what the place has become, you know, I remember when there was the discussion around the name change of the city from Grahamstown to Makhanda, looking at the place that was once filled with a lot of what seemed to be like junk, now suddenly filled with people, you know, a place that was dirty and dusty, now filled like with fresh breath of people alive, and you know, the place just came alive and was filled with life, and there was a stage, there was a platform that people were just speaking life and delivering, you know, the craft and sharing dance, poetry, drama, all these things happening all in one space of filled with young Black people. So it was really epic, it was really dope, and it's still gonna be epic, still gonna be dope, because I know he's not done yet, like, it's still in the process. Like, every time I go there, like, I see something new, like, something new that he's added, something new that he's improved or upgraded or changed, like, it just gets better and better every time. So I know there's a level of excellence that he's aiming to get to, but even right now, the functionality of it is really great. And I know that it's going to raise up a lot of great artists, it's going to raise up, you know, a lot of great talent, it's going to give an opportunity and create a great exposure for a lot of us, you know, from a lot of us artists from Emakhanda. And so, yeah, that's me, Grace Emphatic. Thank you. God bless, my friend. Peace.